Are we on camera?
Yeah, baby.
Just make sure it shows at the wedding tomorrow. It's for filming a bachelor party ever amounted to anything good.
Oh. Last night of freedom. Last night of freedom.
That's up here on the right. Hey, up here on the right.
Where do the high school girls hang out?
I can show it to Sarah later, right?
The single most lucrative commercial enterprise in the world.
The fastest growing crime on the planet.
Look at that girl. Hey, we're gonna get shot.
Boys, yeah. Welcome to heaven.
Sit. It's a reality.
You're talking about hundreds of billions of dollars.
Hey, Mark, we should probably cut the camera.
This is not a lifestyle choice.
It'll be as long as you want to make it, you know.
We live in a world where we don't necessarily know what's going on next door.
Yeah.
I don't even know where we are right now.
Oh, yeah. Some serious massage.
If you're not seeing it, you're not looking for it.
What kind of place is this?
It's everywhere.
It's not even light out. You're somewhere to be. With no hesitation.
The first woman with whom I had a very intimate and sustained conversation was explaining to me that she was approached by a girlfriend who said that the girlfriend had a job for her in a garment factory. And what, in fact, her friend had done was sell her to a man for a week. And she was a virgin, so she had earned her friend what, in their economy, was a significant amount of cash. And the woman, she was late adolescent, was taken to a hotel room where she was kept for a week, and she was raped every day by this man who, when he was done with her, dropped her off at a brothel and said, "You now must earn me back the money that I spent on you."
Stand on the beach.
You can do yum yum. And good? You're good?
Hollywood's shocking new sex trade documentary and the celebrity outrage today. Rarely have we seen stars taking such a strong stand.
Slavery is defined as being forced to work
without pay, under threat of violence,
being economically exploited,
and unable to walk away.
You just had, I know you were expecting a problem when you went in, but you had to be stunned at what you saw, particularly when you're up close and personal to such young girls.
Absolutely. I think the most stunning piece of it is that it's happening in our financial districts. It's not just out in the rural areas or outside of our own lives. It's right in the center of what's happening here.
The system is vast, it is corrupt, it is powerful, it is ruthless, and it's lethal. And the corruption is at the lowest echelons because human trafficking has to exist out in the open so that the demand can access the supply.
There are a lot of girls who are stuck in brothels, but people have to get to work in 30 minutes. They have all kinds of other problems they face.
There are many kinds of exploitation, many kinds of injustice, and many kinds of violence in the world today.
Slavery deserves our attention because it is exploitation, violence, and injustice.
All roll together in the darkest combination.
Music about helping folk, but it helps them by getting them to dance, getting them to move, getting them to think, getting them to reflect, getting them to be themselves, to somehow break out of the conventional self that they are.
The thing that's crazy about this movement is that people are doing things outside of their normal lives. They are pushing the bounds of acceptable behavior inside of activism.
I am unwritten, can't read my mind, I'm undefined. I'm just beginning, the pen's in my hand, ending on.
You know, we celebrate that slavery was abolished and, you know, that we're free.
There's more of it now than
and
ever
then,
in
exactly,
history.
There's more today than there ever was. And that's, it's just more invisible. We just don't know about it. So the clothes and the coffee and tea and different things that we, you know,
That was taken for granted. We don't think about where was it made and under what conditions.
Exactly. And so this is called a rockumentary because they use musicians to actually sing as well. And it's very interesting to watch. Well,
you love those folk who are enslaved in Africa and Asia and Europe and America and so forth. You don't want them to be mistreated. You don't want them to be abused. So you end up fighting for justice even though you started playing your guitar. You say, oh, that's a nice combination. It sure is. That's exactly right. Never forget, justice is what love looks like in public.